Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back into the Zotac Asian Open Qualifier Series number 3. This is our second to last qualifier here for the Asian region, for the SEA region, I should say. There's a couple of direct invites available that we haven't figured out yet. Open qualifiers 1 and 2 have been figured out. Now with 3, I believe top 2 actually make it on. So we actually might see both of these teams heading to the regional qualifier. I'm not 100% sure if that's the case, but just something to keep in mind. As we're going to jump into the game, it's the Prime Man ND versus Geek Fam here in game number 2. Geek Fam dominating the first game. And Trent, I mean, they look pretty solid overall. Some good stuff there.
Oh, looking pretty easy peasy, I gotta say.
Yeah.
And so let me give you guys a little quick rundown here. Basically, the Zotac Cup Masters, ladies and gentlemen, for you who are uninformed, because I know you want to know what is happening at the very moment. You gotta win these little open qualifier things. Any team can come and join. You and your friends, you can hop into these bad boys, win one of these open qualifier slots, and that's what gets you into the regional. Now, these regionals are very exclusive. It is quite legitimately only the open qualifier teams. There will be 4 direct invites, I should say, but if you want a guarantee, you got to play right now. So even if you're like Warriors Gaming Unity, they play through the open qualifier, even though they'd probably get a direct invite, they're like, you know what? You win a little bit of cash if you win. So that's pretty nice. Doesn't hurt, right?
Mm-hmm.
You're guaranteed in. So currently for the Asia Series regional number 1, that already went down. Geek Fam were a part of it. They lost. Mineski were a part. They lost. Clutch Gamers. Yeah, they lost too. So there was Fnatic. And they made it through qualifier number 1. And now, Geek Fam, you got to fight to get in number 2 qualifier. Would you believe it?
Yeah.
So, here they are, trying to do their thing, trying to join RRQ, Pacific Blue, WG Unity, and Slayers.
Oh, I didn't even know Slayers was in
here. And that's where we're at.
Oh, there it is. Yeah, it's
like a tiny little red label.
Yeah, I see it. And they only.
Link the Wikipedia page for you.
Yeah,
guys.
That
there
might be useful. By the way, Trent, really good job there, buddy. Proud of you.
Thanks.
That was pretty good stuff.
Is that Stuntsman in there? Dota Cinema. Hell yeah. I'm so glad.
All right. Let's go. Braxton here. Shane is here. Everybody's here. Let's go, everybody. Hello, guys.
Whew.
So, yeah, that was pretty good game one. Pretty dominant stuff from Geek Fam. I'm a little confused, though, Trent. It does look like you see, if you go back to the SEA Qualifier 1, I do remember that in the open qualifier number 3, 458 Productions and Skyville were both top 2, and they both qualified for the regional qualifiers, which is interesting. But I don't know if that's the case for every single open qualifier, if you know what I mean. Do you understand what I'm saying? Do you
feel me?
Are you picking up what I'm putting down?
I will take whatever you put down, Mark.
Okay, well.
I'm in.
All right, that's moving on. We got some interesting picks. Jug, Legion Commander.
We got the Imba Spirit.
Yeah, Ember 4, Geek Fam, and Ursa, Rubik. Man, we're already well through. Good bands too. Omni Knight band out. Coddle. Some good stuff. What is available that's jumping out at you, Trent? What are you looking at here?
I'm trying to think, like, who won last game, really? I mean, it was kind of Velo on his Legion, seconds, right? So I feel like you give Velo his hero. And his hero is the Timbersaw. So that's, I'm kind of feeling that. My only problem would be they have an Ursa and an Ember Spirit, so you probably want more control. So I can, you know, I could see someone saying no to Timber, but if they got like an Earth Spirit 4 and a Timber 5, or like Timber 5th in this draft, I could see Geek Fam kind of owning.
I actually like Axe against Jug, maybe not against.
Oh yeah, Velo's Axe is also totally ownage. That is a very good point, it's good against Legion Commander.
Yeah.
So.
Yep.
Very acceptable.
Good stuff if they want to go for it. I wouldn't be surprised if that's the case. The Prime already have Legion for their offlaner, so. Jug for their safe lane. It's kind of interesting you pick up both of your cores that early on. For Legion, it makes sense. And like somebody like Alina. And also Jug's pretty good, too. There's good chances he gets manned. Now, I mean, but the problem with this is that they can go for the Magnus. They did that last game. It didn't work out for them. I mean, I guess they could put it mid, but...
Yeah, that's pretty bold to just leave in the Magnus with a Jug. I mean...
Ooh.
Oh, they're going to take the Earth Spirit. No double Radiant spirits for Geek Fam? Unacceptable.
Rough stuff.
Ugh.
Who's the ES player for Geek Fam? Is it Raj? Raji, I think?
It's Monsieur Raji.
Yeah, you're right. It is Raji, yeah.
Send.
Boom.
Even, he plays good Sand Kings.
Oh,
too,
that's
so
more control.
For,
there you go. Yeah. That's what you're talking about, man. We've seen some good Sand Kings recently. Cough, cough, yeah. Tavo. Cough, cough.
Does get ditched a lot these days, though, I have to say.
And, yeah, well, that makes sense, I suppose. I don't know. Is it really that bad of a thing? You're pretty good on your own.
10 seconds remaining. Yeah, with the Rubik, it's an okay setup too. So I would guess this is probably a 4 Sand King. I'm not really expecting it to be a an offlaner, especially against Jug. I mean, it's like okay, but he's got the healing ward. He's kind of fine.
I gotta let him know where it's at, Trent. I gotta let him know. I'm not getting ditched again, man. It's just not happening. Oh, sorry, I'm in a four stack. Yeah, whatever.
Huh. All right. We're going to get an OD, the classic Earth Spirit OD. So they're only missing their five for Prime and D. Crystal Maiden's still in the pool, so you ban that shit
out. So weird to see the five getting picked last. It's not something
you expect. It's a pretty rare event.
Yeah, I would say so. We'll see what's going to be here for their fifth position support. As you mentioned, CM is a definite possibility. CM Earth Spirit, I like it. Didn't work out for them in game one, but that's all right. Couple more brands coming in. Geek Fam is one more. They're also looking for their four position, theoretically. Unless Rubik is, but
No, it's gonna be four Sand King. I'm telling you, Mott. I'm telling you right now, that's a Raji Sand King if I've ever seen one of my goddamn life. I would stake my reputation on this being a Raji Sand King.
Look out. Trent's reputation's on the line, everybody. Here it comes. Look out.
Now, since you're not Suns fan, I'll be right. But if you're a Suns fan, I'd be wrong. Even if it was the exact same
Little
question.
Do you know, I'm Suns fan with a voice modulator. Got him.
Ah, damn.
Classic. However, it is a mag ban, so they seem to think the same thing. They seem to think this is a force ranking. And that's fine. Not a bad choice. And they can still
that's
go
a
axe.
Good choice.
That is solid. Always good.
Yeah, the CM route, it's pretty good against Ember Spirit, but Stag Storm is much better against Ursa. You get yourself the old silence, so we can't enrage, and then of course also very good against just Ember in general. You don't get the benefits of Arcane Aura, but that's okay. They don't have the most needy heroes. They get an OD. That's your Arcane Aura right there, right?
Yeah.
It's a cake.
Pretty good stuff. Remaining. Pretty good stuff for the Prime Man and D. But we did think that the draft in game number one was a little bit scary for Geek Fam to deal with. But it's not the case this time, perhaps, so we'll see.
Oh, I think you might be right with Axe.
I know, man.
Yeah. I don't know.
I'm staking my reputation on it, Trent.
All of it.
Yeah. No, all right. Well.
Ooh, a Doom. Okay. That is not something they play, like, ever.
You were right. It is a four-position Sand King. Probably, yeah, it is. Velos picked up the Doom. God damn it. By the way, I like this better. It shows the names. You know, we have to wait until that, like, anime
That's
screen
true.
Comes up. I don't know why they just don't do this and then add the anime screen in later. Like, come on! It's easier this way.
Tell them, Mott.
Yeah, I'm sure Val's listening. I'm sure they're listening to me. It's like one of those small things that's never going to get fixed or changed. And if it does, I'll take credit for it. But anyway, we're going to jump into the game.
They've only played four games of Doom. The last one was 17 days ago.
It's a while.
That's how long ago it was.
What did
it's
he buy? Tell me what he bought, Trent.
What did he buy? It was both games were against Mineski. The last two times they did it, that is. One was C-Kappa.
Uh-huh.
So I guess that was obviously us. Missed that one. That was a Raji Slider as well to help out. No problem. And it looks like he was down with the, let's see here.
Trent,
Midas.
Let me tell you, you did not miss that one. You just can't remember because you did literally every C-Kappa game.
Yeah, no, I believe you. I just can't remember.
That's okay. I understand it happens. I didn't mean to throw you under the bus like that, buddy. Sorry. Anyway, we're jumping into the game. Tatsumaki, playing up the Earth Spirit. Already rotating down with a smoke and two wards, interestingly enough. We'll see where he drops it, probably to block this camp, potentially. Just outside, so actually not going to get it. Raji's going to see him. He's got Burrow Strike. I don't know if that's what you want, but I guess to get up a stun, yeah, it's probably not. I mean, he's a four-position support, so it's not surprising. More lag coming out. Important to note, there was a storm, I think, for Geek Fam, and they were really like considering not playing, and they were like,
oh, really?
That's fine. We'll just play later. And the admin talked to him, and he's like, yeah, okay, we'll play. I think he told him that we were going to come and cast it, and that's probably why. He's like, all right, fine. The people, that's what they want. Understandably so. We've got a lot of sway over here in Zotac, let me tell you.
What do you think, Mott? Do you think I should get Prime so I can have four things in front of my name? That actually sounds
that's
amazing.
That's too much, man. You're crazy. You're crazy.
I think that's the way to go. That sounds good. That's like I've seen.
That's
I remember
the
there was a night dev person who I think also works at Twitch. So they have like the night bot the night thing dev. Too, and they have a little thing.
Do they have the verify on top of it?
So they could probably get verified. They could probably get like five or like six with a staff badge. That would be amazing.
Just a bunch of shit in front of your name. It's just like, wow, great. It's great. Excellent. Anyways,
right.
Versace on the floor looking to have a better game than game number one where he died about 12 times, in the first like 20 minutes.
This poor guy.
Dude, like the one, I think
you're just this Crystal Maiden who can't afford a Ghost Scepter.
It was summed up by the death that he had top lane where he frostbited Psionics and then died. He just literally walked up and died. Oh, that's not good for LNFR. That is not good. Ned is already, he's like, listen, you're not going anywhere. That's, well, he does, he is in the dire side, so they can't stay here forever. But Ned could just stay under this tower potentially. And
I mean, someone's going to come down here to help him out, right?
At like, some point, yes.
That's still at least a support rotation.
I mean, they, honestly, is it worth it for Raji and Ned just to stay here? Like, at what point does this become not worth it?
You definitely leave a Rubik, so when the guy comes to help,
oh,
you telekinesis
oh,
him up.
Oh, dude, what is happening?
They're going for the kill. He's like, I can burrow down. I don't know. This is a bit risky, though.
This is risky. How much damage? Look how much damage he's taking. Moment
what
of courage is outing
him. Down?
Get out of
Save
there.
Save me.
Oh, what? What?
What?
What? What are you doing? Get out of there, Raji.
Run. All right. In the end, that was totally worth it, right?
Was it? Look how much damage Raji took. Who's that worth it for? I don't understand what you're...
Did you fix the damn overlay?
Is it fixed? Oh, it's a little. Oh, yeah, it's a little big. My bad, guys. Sorry, everybody. Well, nobody told me previously.
Was it like that the whole time?
Probably, yeah. But it was only over the freaking like icon of the hero. Who cares, honestly? If you care that much about the overlay, go watch the.
I
major.
Mean, I agree. It's pretty big, dude. I'm just saying. I think chat's got this one on you. Like it's right over the.
All right. Well, Versace's dead again, dude. Jesus Christ. Dude, he is having, like, the worst series possible. No offense to him. It's just not going well. You know, you got to feel bad.
Not having a fun time.
At least the OD is getting some good last hits. He's got 8 right now against the Ember 6 for Teehee. And remember last game, pretty much what happened was GeekFam got off to a fast start and didn't slow down. And we'll see if the Prime NND will have the same sort of luck. NFR is getting chased out. This is one of those matchups that it's actually not great. Bro Strike is going to come out. Fade Bolt isn't available. It's still level one. He doesn't even need it. Sanix will secure the kill. And it's like Legion is usually really good, but against Zenursa, good luck. And that's really any hero in a solo lane. Oh, he missed that CS. I saw it.
If you hate the enemy's offlaner, you pick Ursa. I mean, that's pretty much the life, right? Like, if that's their best player, and you're like, you know what? If we just shut this guy down, I think we have a really good shot of winning this. Just pick Ursa. What are they going to do? The offlane's awful. You, like, have to jungle the whole time.
Ursa is so
can't
good,
make
too,
plays.
Right now.
Like, see that? He had phase boots queued up on this Legion, and he just went, oh, right, Ursa, my life sucks.
Bye,
Quelling
Blade.
Blade, boys. I'm
out of here. I'm surprised he didn't cube the Iron Talon completely. That's how bad this lane is going. Meanwhile, Ember Spirit is caught back up in terms of forward CCS. Can you spot him? Raji coming in, he's got that Burrow Strike, overwhelming odds. Press the attack, not available, and this is maybe a dead LFNR. Yeah, he gets killed. The Earthshot comes out, and Sanix says thank you very much. So. What a miserable game. Can they get this kill on Teehee, though? Sleight of Fist coming out. Tatsumaki came through, I think, with a Rolling Boulder. Wasn't successful. Teehee's got a backup. Has a salve, by the way. I'm surprised he doesn't have a bottle or anything like that. He bought an Iron Talon on the Ember Spirit, too, which I think is kind of interesting. I guess it is kind of a rough lane, but...
Yeah, exactly. This is that lane where you're going to the jungle. You know what's coming. And ever since the draft even started, you're like, yeah, they'll just pick OD. The classic anti-Ember.
Dude, LNFR doesn't even have a
Quelling
Blade.
It's very helpful in lane, too, right? It's not just
Yeah, that's
camps.
True. Yeah, it is pretty solid. He's actually not doing poorly. I mean, the wave is pushing in now. 15 last hits to the 19. I mean, it'll get worse, for sure. But meanwhile, rotations potentially from Tatsumaki. The Thunder small person herself.
Yeah, he's got a little bit of a hard time this game. Ganking mid is definitely his best chance. He's this OD, and they might finally get it going, but it's like 3.5 minutes in, and he isn't really hitting
They could start
anymore.
With the Astral, potentially, if they want to. But I don't know if they're going to. TP's coming in. It actually, they're close to the 2-2 tower. Teehee actually still just fine. Maybe not Boulder Smash. They do have Astral, but not nearly enough. Teehee's actually pretty tanky. Boorman shield up, and he has to back up and heal, which is fine. So again, the gang not
like...
successful. And
yeah.
How's top lane going? You know, because there isn't an Earth Spirit here, he's fine. He's an Iron Talon. Versace is going to be spotted again. They know exactly where his Kinetic Field comes out. Telekinesis, they have Bro Strike ready to go, and they're going to use it momentarily, probably just to secure the kill. They don't even need it, actually. Tries to deny himself, and that's Raji getting another kill picked up.
Dude,
so.
What is this Aztec Doom shit going on? This guy's terrifying.
Hold on a second. Yeah, what is this?
Have you seen this? He looks like a weird Wraith King. He's like jacked Wraith King or something.
Yeah, I don't know what this set
is. This is quite the helmet.
It looks pretty intense, to be honest with you.
He looks like he's from, like, Might and Magic or something.
Looks
I don't
like
know.
A Dreadlord or something, or Doomguard, excuse me, from
It really
Warcraft.
Does not look like Doom. I would, like, if I saw the screenshot, like, imagine if you couldn't see those wings, man. You'd just be like, Dude, is this a new hero?
He definitely does look like a Doomguard.
Is this
Doomfist?
Are we playing Overwatch?
I don't even know what that is.
That's, I only know the name. I don't even know what he looks
yeah,
like.
Yeah, I don't know what he looks
but
like
I
either.
But, I mean, if I picture the guy named Doomfist, this is it's starting to look
well,
like
Well, I don't know. Doomfist just makes me think he's got a really giant fist and, like, he's a normal person otherwise. Brushstrike, bottom lane. Earthshock, he does have press the attack, but my god, the overpower, the Fury swipes across the finale. More than enough to get the kill for Psyonix, and again, the Legion's life is even more miserable. Top lane, Vilo getting dove. They have the Blade Fury coming out. He might dive here. He's got stick charges. Meanwhile, Nets nearby. Telekinesis is really close. Can he get there? They're going to go for Versace and said, so come on, man. No, please.
Not me.
Not again. God. Jesus. It's one of those fuck my life situations. Oh, T's got to wait 18 seconds for this freaking shrine. Rough stuff.
It must be nice to be Psyonix in this game. You know, you play this Terror Blade last game, and yeah, you're owning, and you're like getting so much farm. But it's probably a little boring, just because the game, like, he didn't really do too much, his team was doing shit, and now you play this Ursa, and you already have 3 kills, you got an assist, it's 5.5 minutes in, you're just thinking about Roche, and you're like, man, I'm going to get this Blink Dagger, and I'm just going to eat people. You know, I'm going to eat this jug. Just dead.
Yeah, it's not, good. It's a lot more fun for Psyonix, and interestingly enough, it's not actually like the Dire doing that poorly, even with the kill score going the way that it is. It's just, you know, Xanax is doing really well. OD's actually doing pretty good. And the Jug is about sort of tied with the Ember Spirit, which is to be expected, I'd say, after he was getting pushed back out top lane. But we'll see how things go. We'll see what happens next. All right. Here we go. Nets just leeching experience. And Raji is going to take some mid lane experience at farm. Rustman does have a double damage rune, which isn't great. Also going for the double null tally again, like you mentioned, pretty prominent, pretty classic stuff here as of recently, just to win the lane. So
yeah, it's all about these days, them nullies. I'm waiting for the null tail or null tail.
Hey,
man, we need null tail and end hero. We need those nullies in the blade mail on the prophet, man. You got that buff damage. Prophet is insane right now, man. You get that Blightstone, the amount of damage you do in lane is actually just disgusting.
So we're going to go full circle with the double null talisman build for Nature's Prophet, right?
That's what I'm hoping.
Get back to that point that we were at like 2 years ago.
If only Liquid was still, you know, chugging along with the Major, man. Get the Prophet mid going again, maybe.
Yeah, perhaps. Well, that's not going to happen now, but that'd be cool, you're right. All right, well, they've switched the lanes up. They sent Psyonix top lane. They're like, all right, well, we've already dominated LNFR. Let's dominate the El Panda instead. Overpower comes out. Kill that healing ward. No, maybe not. All right. Psyonix, all that damage is going to be... Actually, it's not even healing up that fast because it's level 1, so... Look at that. It only healed up maybe like 20% of the damage that he just did.
Plus, they know that this...
Doom on mid. He's dead. That's the rotation. He had just gotten level 6 Velo getting... involved early on, by the way.
Oh, meanwhile.
I didn't even see that. He came up with the overpower and the enrage. Level 3 Fury Swipes, in fact. His Vlads will be done momentarily. In fact, 600 more gold. Psyonix is just... His tower's going to get pushed, too. They know Versace's in here, by the way. Somebody pinged him. I don't know who it was.
Yeah, he just, like, ran back there. He is a TP, so maybe they thought he might have left. But either way, they don't care. Roger will go do the scare.
Oh, they're coming in. Oh,
they got the scan.
They see him. Ooh, nice. Bob Ross. Kinetic Field coming out. Uh-oh, Psyonix might be in trouble. Actually, it's El Panda. Maybe not. They get the kill. Blade Fury does the job. And now the Brush Striker from Raji trying to find that TP. But the Boulder Smash is there from Tatsumaki. And the duel. They even popped the Omni Slash to get the kill. So, you're right. That was a happy little tree. Happiest little tree possible.
That was a hell of a turnaround there. Okay.
Dude, that Bob Ross play actually saved them. If they had lost both of those heroes there, this game just gets out of hand. And that's what happens when you're Ursa, you don't have enraged, and when you're up against like the Blade Fury, you just take too much damage.
Gold, too. It's like a 1300 gold swing.
It's a bit
rough. Early in the game, that's a little scary.
I mean, you gotta find a lot more than that as the prime NND, but at least they're getting some more. LNFR also got a dual victory, and I mean, he is so far behind.
Yeah, it'll help him jungle faster, right? 10 damage.
Woo! That's true.
Oh, and then this OD just comes and takes all your farm.
He's got the Essence Aura.
Seriously, dude.
Spam yourself, LNFR. Come on now. Do it.
Oh, I might have to agree on that one. That seems like a missed opportunity.
But what if you spam it and all your mana's gone?
Just... I guess he really needs to press the attacks.
Yeah.
Make sure his sustain's going.
Well, anyway, OD is now top of the net worth after dying earlier. There's the phase done. He's rich. He's got phase boots for the LNFR Leech Commander. Midas is going to be next for the Doom. Dire's top tower is under attack. All right. Ice
really
going to
get this Vlad's going. I want to see a Roche happen here.
He's just about got... Oh. Thunderstrike.
Pressing forward without Omni Slash here, but just trying to counterbalance the pressure that's coming in top lane. So pretty good play. They see Doom doesn't have a TP, which is nice, so they can know that he won't be there immediately. However, the two supports are coming.
Yeah, we'll see. Ember Spear pops the Remnant just to be sure he's okay. Raji, oh, nobody saw it. Don't worry. Nobody saw it.
Hey, steals the Banner Rune too. Nice play, Tatsumaki.
Ownage.
All right, things already looking quite a bit better, honestly, even though they're still behind. I mean, there's no doubt there's almost a 3k lead being built up here that Gifan previously had. They just got to fight their way back to it a little bit here. There is that Midas now coming up for the Doom, though, and then he gets this Devour bonus gold of 80, and your life's awful.
Yeah, he's going to get a lot of farm. Yeah. Level 10, by the way, is that talent is pretty insane. Yeah, so far so good for Geek Fam. Again, they've sort of kind of taken over in terms of the net worth once more. The Ember Spirit's found some room to farm. Picking up bots seems to be the new hot thing. I wouldn't say new, but
it's like more popular. At first, it was a much smaller percentage of Ember players doing it, then now it seems to be gone.
Psionics pops the Enrage. Do they have Static Storm? They absolutely do. He actually might die here. Burrow Strike might come in, but Idle Planet does have to play Fury. Glimps back out onto Raj. Doom came in onto LNFR. Burrow onto two. The Epicenter getting channeled. And should be enough to at least find one of these kills, if not both of them. Omni Slash comes out, brings down the Rubik, but still, this is not looking that great. The Sanity's coming in, wants the kill. They do a little bit of damage to at least Raji. Meanwhile, Astral comes out in Velo. Tatsumaki's so low, but staying alive. Caustic Finale not bringing him down. They're all solo. The Healing Ward is there. Now the Remnant's coming in. They want this kill desperately. He has Sleight of Fist, Searing Chains, gets it off, but the Rolling Boulder completes anyways. As they will Shrine up.
God,
I can't believe they survived. That Shrine was intense. Rustman now coming in and turning on. Raji doesn't have enough mana for a Burst Strike, I don't believe. Boulder Smash, Silence now onto T. He's Psionics. Finally respawns. Pretty good fight there from the Dire team. Good stuff.
Very much so. Again, it's only two more kills, and they trade two, but that's still going to be advantageous for them. That's a lot of gold to that Doom, though. Jeez. He is making the money. Gonna have drums here in a moment.
That Midas about to be off cooldown. Please, Velo. This creep wave mid, do it.
Nah, he's gonna rotate that jungle. Don't give it away.
Oh, yes, the range creep. Bristman doesn't seem to know something's up, though. Sleight of Fist, Searing Chains. Burrow Strike if needed. It's not. Spell stolen. Guess what? It's Astral. And good
all right,
stuff.
Not punished. Excellent. For Velo, not so much for the Dire.
I was like, damn, dude. They're trying their best. But, it's a pretty good kill there. Velo has Doom back up in a minute. Tatsumaki, Versace, and LaPanda heading down bottom to get the tier 1 tower. Glyph.
Quite the fashion line going on, man.
Versace,
Tatsumaki. I don't know. These sound like some El Panda.
Yeah, I can see that easily being
a clothing
line for sure.
El Panda, that sounds pretty good.
From the
That's very fresh.
El Panda.
It sounds like some hipster clothing line. Are there hipsters in Asia? Are they down?
Oh, for sure, absolutely.
All right. Okay. All right.
Yeah, definitely. Especially
they got some fedoras going
especially
on.
Especially in Korea,
vests.
Especially in Korea and Japan, for sure, absolutely.
Okay. All right. Good. Good. Glad I don't even know
if they're. I don't even think they're hipsters there. What we consider hipster, they consider like common fashion wear. I'm pretty sure. You know what? That's a generalization. I don't know if it's true or not. I'm just making shit up as I go along. So.
All right, that's fine. That's cool. Generalizations are in. They're hip right now.
They are hip, dude. Let me tell you. Here in America, they're super hip.
Yeah, I've heard your president. He loves generalizations.
Whether they're true or not. This political commentary brought to you by the duo commentary team of Trent Pax and Watt.
No problem. Roche knocked down. So, Psionics will grab the Cheeto itself. The Aegis.
Excuse me, the what?
The Cheeto.
The Cheeto?
President Cheeto. Anyway, I don't know. It's kind of orange.
Oh, that Legion's dead. Doom, Fade Bolt. Oh, deny? He's trying. Oh, he was pretty close, I will say. He's pretty close.
Almost.
Oh, he's still overwhelming odds. That's nasty.
That's coming bottom.
He canceled the TP. He canceled the TP. Xanax is here alone. I don't know if Xanax knows that he's alone. I guess he has Aegis, so whatever. Xanax doesn't really care at this point. He's like, I need Blink badly. But Trent, it's not looking good here for this this Dire team again.
No. They're making the right moves at this point, though, I feel like. You know, maybe if they could get a smoke going and use the level 2 Omni Slash if Alpanda could get there. That could be a nice next moment for them. Their OD is still working on that 4-staff. Really needs an item.
Yeah, he's a little away. He's like 1,000 spotted gold away from the 4-staff. So, all right. Net worth-wise, of course, this Doom is starting to widen the gap. You see this little thing on the net worth graph that just kind of jumps up? That's essentially the 80 devour gold of the Midas kicking in for the Doom. That's what that
that's
is.
Every time, yeah.
Yeah. That's, right,
here comes our smoke. Radiant Vision looks like non-existent over here. So we have a OD mid. Maybe this will be enough then. Showing that. Oh,
he's going to die in the same spot,
this
too.
This is Vision right here. He doesn't
oh,
see
my God.
Still.
Wow, they finally just walk in. Overwhelming odds comes out. The kinetic field is there. The comes back. He still has some rage, and he also still has Aegis. They're actually having a tough time bringing him down. That's literally just one of his lives. And Vila's coming in. He's like, let's fight. I don't have Doom, but I have Ice Armor. Static Storm will come out. They're looking for Versace again. Please, no, please. He's actually fine. Tatsumaki, Sleight of Fist, certain chance to come out. Nice save from Rustman with the Astra coming in. See, he's trying to turn this around. Got up the Flame Guard. They get off one auto attack to bring that poor Earth Spirit down, and Rustman's going to get caught and killed next to Sionix. Finds himself a double kill. Now Vila looking to turn again. Still no deep for another 30 seconds.
They all just DC'd.
Oh, that is the worst time for that
like,
to happen.
Why is that Legion standing perfectly still?
Huh. Well, I wonder if the Earth Spirit and the Rustman died because of that, too. I'm kind of interested.
Couldn't really tell, to be honest. It kind of looked like they were all moving until that. So I think it was, you know, Legion's really the only one that, to me,
will die because of this. That makes sense.
But it's hard to tell.
Man, if I was them, I'd be mega triggered. Still.
Yeah.
I think if you're Vila, you back away. Don't dive this. Just be... Yep.
Oh, look
good
at
lads.
That.
Good
look
lads.
At those good manners.
Good lads, man. Let me tell you. Dude, when I see that shit, I love it so much. It makes me so happy. I love it.
There you go, guys. Geek Fam's got the man. I mean, because Ember had 3 remnants. Like, that was a dead Legion if you wanted
to
be
absolutely.
A dead Legion. Yeah.
That's absolutely a dead hero if they want it to be. But the manners coming out from Geek Fam, and more often than not, that will happen for just about every pro game. There are probably some teams that would be out there and that would do that anyway, but, like, I don't know. For some reason, it really just gets me going. When I see stuff like that, it makes me really happy. So, good stuff.
Good for you guys, Geek Fam.
Yeah.
They're also kind of owning, so that helps so the situation.
There's no
bit.
Need really to do that.
To be
also,
honest.
I mean, if there was like, if they were down, like, on the opposite sort of, like, if this was kind of reversed, maybe they go for it, but probably not. I'm not trying to say that, you know. Oh, Jesus. Well, LNFR, you lived pretty long, and then you backed up, and they let you live, and then you're going to die to a Doom, so. My God. Bots? Dude, Bots Drum? Are you kidding? Do you know how insanely fast he is?
He is one speedy Doom.
Yeah, dude. It's crazy. Now all he needs is, like, I don't know, an SMY? Maybe. Scorched Earth also is pretty good. Top lane, Blank Burrow, L Panda, dead.
Mid lane, they use Static Storm, but they can't quite grab Teehee.
Yeah, but he's fine. He has a Yule Scepter, by the way, too, so even if he gets Static Storm, he should be fine.
Yeah. That Cheevas guard, though, up against Legion in her duel, up against OD. Fantastic heroes of Cheevas.
Oh, maybe he is dead. Teehee trying to remnant out, will make it away. One more auto attack. Magnetize actually is going to kill
mana.
Him. The Magnetize was huge. Good stuff there.
That's
big
the thing
drop.
About Yules too. Like it is very costly. 175 mana is a lot for an Ember Spirit.
Yeah, you only 650 total. It's pretty rough for sure. Blank Burrow comes out. They'll find Tatsumaki. The kinetic field comes out, but they do have Rubick with Astral if they want to use it. But we'll see if that's gonna be the case. Anyway, Vila might die here. Pops the drum charge. Just kidding. He is insanely fast. With drum, he has 520 movement speed. So, woo!
Doom. Oh, Theonix, he tried. He tried.
Dude, he
so
really
hard
did.
To blink steal that bat.
Yeah. Vilo's like, nope. That's pretty funny. Speaking of Blinked and Doom, both of them. Actually, Doom's down for 40 seconds, but Alpan is like, I'm out of here. Meanwhile, Duel comes out. They actually will find this Rubick. Nets in probably the worst spot he could have been in.
Yeah, probably trying to get some aggressive vision going.
I mean, that's fine, but you don't really need to give away too much this game. You're already so far ahead. Speaking of which, it is now 10,000 up to 1,200 net worth advantage for Psionics. Again, like this little jump up here, that's when the Doom sort of really came online. And it's been a steady upward climb since then, not looking down at any point in time. So, and he's going to have a Sheep's Guard soon, too.
Yeah, the Radiance would have been really good this game, too, if he wanted to go for it.
Eh, whatever. He just needs 1,000 gold for the Shivas, and when he has that, the game doesn't necessarily end, but it might as well.
That's so good on this hero. He might be one of the best.
With Shivas? Yeah, that makes sense. Also makes him way tankier, too. He already has the 23 armor because he has the Flame Elf. Doom comes out. They're going to try to bots in. Good juke, but they have Telekinesis, which they will use. Press the attack comes out. Good duel to turn this around. They may very well find Net, but the Evil Scepter is there. Tatsumaki jumping in. Magnetize will be used. They blow away Net. Jumping in, though, the Enrage comes out. They absolutely disintegrate this poor Earth Spirit and the Magnetize.
And this is a jug buyback. So yep. They're just like, yep, no thanks. And then they're like, okay, actually, you know what? Yeah, let's get a dive.
Sleight of Fissurian Chains. Versace is dead. Goodbye. Astra comes out to save Rustman, but then the Burrow Strike just to set up. And the Sleight of Fist gets the kill for Teehee. Omni Slash coming in, Psionics. Gotta get Glimpse back, still so low. He doesn't have Enrage, one more auto attack, and he will find it. So they do pick up that huge kill on Psionics.
Oh, God.
Perhaps a little too much of an aggression there. How much gold did they get out of that? Did he didn't make money, unfortunately, even from killing the Ursa. In fact, the Ursa didn't even lose money for that death, which is insane. The only body that made a fair bit of money was 591 gold for this Legion Commander, which is not great, as everybody else died and bought back. Well, two other people died and bought back, and then two others just died.
Cool. Those are some intense buybacks, man.
Oh, for sure.
I don't know. They lost a lot on that. Raj, you just gonna kind of shadow this. Oh, no, he's gonna come in. He's gonna try and get the damage off this wave, see how much he can burst on, but Panda will get the spin off, and this might cost Raj.
I believe he's gonna die if he's not careful. They do have no more Blade Fury, so actually, do they have detection? He just burrows out. Oh my god, he almost killed him too. Alpana needs to what a blank with that overwhelming odds. Raji's making plays, baby. Dude, he can go for another burrow. He can kill Alpana. He should see him right now. Yep, he's dead. Psionic Storm comes out. He's like, you know what? Psionic, you just take care of this. That is miserable there. Oh my god, he finds Versace. Does he have the burrow strike? What? What? Raji?
What?
He missed the burrow. He didn't use it. Because, he was TPing out, and he just got... All right, so Ryze is kind of...
You know what? I was actually on Dire Vision, and I couldn't tell that Disruptor was TPing. I don't know. That was really weird. The, like, little white border didn't look right.
It was hard to tell because there was trees. Even in the both vision, it was difficult to tell. By the way, Velo dies and gave away a Wicked Six tree.
Oh, sorry. I was in Radiant Vision, I meant to say. But, yeah, that is really weird. I don't know.
LNFR got all that gold, by the way.
His cool... That burrow was on cooldown for a really long time. I'm thinking he didn't notice he was TPing. That's
he
the
definitely,
only
exactly. That's what I. He definitely had burrow. I'm pretty sure I clicked on him and I saw it.
Yeah, 100% he did.
Yeah. I mean, these things happen. I don't think he was playing with him. I think he was really waiting for that TP and he just didn't see it, honestly, like you mentioned. Whatever, though. No big deal. Again, they really. The big thing is they lose Velo top lane to the Legion Commander. Meanwhile, Teehee getting up the Maelstrom has to be expected. He's already gone for the 10% spell application. He's got the plus 6 stats. What is this? I actually haven't seen this level 20 talent too often. What is it usually for Ember Spirits? I guess it depends on the game. What do you think?
Yeah, I would say it's probably the game. I've seen the 500 Flame Guard most of the time, though. I mean, let's be honest. It's actually disgusting.
It's insane, yeah. I feel like it depends, though, obviously. It's like... It's cool
there
because it's
games where there's just not that much magic.
I like the choices between magic and armor. I feel like it's like getting a BKB or not, you know what I mean? Sort of thing. Yeah.
The only thing is it's only 10 armor though, so I'd say it's like 80 to 90% of the time you're getting the Flame Guard.
I mean, especially if you have like an aura on your team with some sort of armor. Or you get another defensive item later.
You want that Flame Guard damage.
I mean, and let's be honest, Velo has ice armor, so it's not like he needs any more. Ice Armor, which gives, of course, the 8 bonus armor. By the way, I do think Ice Armor is one of the best for the early game if there's a lot of right-click. Like, 8 bonus armor is insane at, like, 10 minutes in. Anyway. They're going to push. They're probably going to take the Tier 2 tower. They're going for the trade on the Radiant side, or excuse me, the Dire side towards the Radiant Tier 1 top lane. Dude, this game is so bad that El Panda has been sitting on Yasha for literally ever. He hasn't gotten his bounty yet. He's going to finally get it now, but... like, rough game. And meanwhile, Ruspin only has a Hurricane Pike with this Midas. That's how badly this is going. Like, my god, dude. Meanwhile, Velo's like, I'm rich, bitch.
You get a lot of value out of your Nulls by keeping the Hurricane Pike. So, it, like, rather than getting a second item, you just get both. Because you're getting, like, 2 items, you know what I mean? And then they morph into 1, so... it is still kind of rough. I mean, he's still the most farmed person on his team.
Yeah,
and he's almost up there with
Ursa. Yeah, he's set with Ursa, surprisingly
enough. Just looks really poor.
Right, exactly. That's my point. Does he have anything on the courier? He does have an extra 1,000 gold in his inventory currently. LNFR smoking up with Tatsumaki and the rest of the crew, so two ships passing in the night, not going to find each other. Say, how do you do once they find a mid, perhaps? But they do see where Ruspin is. He walked over this ward. And they are going to head in that direction now.
Yeah, they see the courier as well.
Can they get it? Do they want to get it?
The
problem
sure
is they're not smoked up. If they had another smoke, they would go again, I think. They don't have one. Instead, they're just going to head to Roche. Just fine.
Darsh, 100% know this is happening right
should
now.
Should they go for it is the question. Net, spell stolen. Glimpse back. Interestingly, Net steals healing ward, by the way, which is pretty insane. Searing chains come out. Roche is dead. Sam gets the Aegis, and there's that. And now there's a blink up for the Doom, too. So blink team is now available. As it's flying out, he actually sent it to the side ship, which is kind of interesting. But
all right, well, if they're not going to fight there, then they're going to wait until high ground for sure.
Or they're just going to kill Tatsumaki.
Yeah, that was unlucky, but very unfortunate. I shouldn't say unlucky. I guess I just mean like they need to fight high ground, but now it's going to be very difficult. Excellent ward coming out here from the Radiant. That's why they get that kill. So not luck based whatsoever. But
I like what they're doing on the Dire side. They should be able to get the tower.
It's like the best possible thing you can do, honestly.
Yeah.
But they're just going to get burnt.
They did have a glyph.
High ground.
Too soon. Yeah, they need to get back now. It's taking them a while to take this tier 2 tower.
They have no glyph. So this is just a dead tier 3, it looks like.
Yeah, I don't think they can defend this. They will get the tower. They're going to end up TPing back now.
Oh, Zaxora? September.
Magnetic field. They use it. They're going to jump in. Versace is dead. At least he got his ultimate off. That's great. Omnislash doing literally nothing against the armor of Velo. Blink Burrow onto 2 coming in. Slide of Fissuring Chains. Doom is up, and they blow them away. No buyback available for us, man. They get off the Yule Scepter up onto El Panda, who's already used his Blade Fury. He's got the Healing Ward. Nice Boulder Smash, but it might not be enough to stand. It blows him away. Slide of Fissuring Chains again used. Alan Afar throwing up the Overwhelming Odds. Doing okay damage against Sanix as an Aegis, so he doesn't really care. They would have liked to have Healing Ward, I think. They stole Blade Fury instead. Jump in. Speaking of Blade Fury, El Panda has to use it. They get off the Aegis at the very least, but here comes the Shiva's Guard. El Panda slowed up. Now that Blade Fury is down, I'm not sure if they can do anything. They force out so many buybacks. They really want this Baylor Rex at the very least, and they should be successful in getting it. Again, how many sessions has already been used? Light of Fissuring Chains. Again, the Healing Ward about to go down, so if they take any further damage, it's just going to be pretty rough at this point. More Blade Furies to come in. They don't want to get caught too far. They've already done a lot of damage to that Ranger Rex. There's no Trim Protector this game. Glimps back, they have the jewel up on Velo, and he's in some trouble, even with that armor, but the Burrow Strike comes out, they might be able to bring him down, not enough. Coming in to see here, another Sleight of Fissuring Chains coming out, El Panda's gonna go down. GG is called, Geek Fam, one of the most solid 2-0s you're gonna ever see.
Yeah. Nice and crisp, pretty clean gameplay, not very many mistakes, honestly, from them. They rarely overextended, and they just kind of played some clean drafts right through to the victory. First draft, I mean... talk about the synergy that was there from our opponents here. But Geek Fam was a little bit too good. Xeonix and that Terrorblade took over. And no shot this time for the Dire in terms of making it into the regional. But Geek Fam will be there. So they'll join all those teams we listed earlier. And we'll see who else will be joining them from the direct invite list.
Yeah, that's going to be the most interesting part of the regional qualifiers. Hold on a second. I'm asking a question to the admins. I'm trying to figure out whether or not top 2 move on or it's just the first place people move on. If it's top 2, then...
it's just the first.
All right. Well, good job to Geek Fam to get through. Nope.
Wait,
top 2 moves on.
Top 2 moves.
All right.
Why?
Told you.
Since when?
I don't know. It's just
that
how
always
it is.
The thing?
I guess it might have been.
Oh, my
so
bad.
This game
oh,
doesn't
yeah,
even matter.
Right. It is top two. Well,
this game really didn't even matter, but just kind of putting on display.
For the money.
Yeah, I mean, Difference Makers, Geek Fam, just they look a lot better, honestly. And good, really good stuff from them. So, yeah, that's going to be it. We have Europe tomorrow for more regional or open qualifiers, excuse me. And we should see some interesting teams moving on. I believe it's the last EU open qualifier, by the way, which is very exciting. So we'll see if that's
going to
be the case.
The NA one that didn't matter. That's what the NA one, it was only the final team one. That's why I was confused. Apologies.
So very good stuff there. Thanks for watching, guys. I really appreciate you coming by. Of course, make sure you guys check out the major. I'm sure you have two monitors already up and going. But
there's a major on?
Yeah, I know, dude. It's crazy.
Oh, my God. I got to go, Mott.
Well, hold on, Trent.
Oh, faceless.
Trent,
right
hold
now.
On. Trent, hold on.
I got to go.
No. Let me ask you a question. Are you playing some PUBG later or now?
I got to run a 10K today. I don't know.
God damn it.
That's looming over me, so I'm probably going to try and get that done in like 2 hours or so. I don't
All
know.
Right, well.
I think I kind of want to watch OG Faceless.
That's fine. Nobody
Bye,
wants
everybody.
To play with me. I'm going to go cry. I'll see y'all later. The VODs will be up on YouTube at some point in the future. See y'all later. Bye, guys.